Welcome back to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to giving a brief description about metallurgical microscope. We are going to perform the complete assembly of this microscope. Also we will see some output on some metal parts of observation with this complete setup. In this video we will cover the complete working of this microscope. Metallurgical microscopes generally used in casting and forging type of industries, where they can find out the proper casting of the material or the objects they are forming, and there are a lot of applications of this metallurgical microscope they can perform in the any metal casting or metal related ferrous, non-ferrous or copper type of industries. Move on further, in this video we will see all the parts related which are need to be assembled for proper working of this microscope, and later on we will see some images of some metal samples. So this is the closer look of this microscope. The order code is 22235668.1. You can use this order code to find out exact specification of this microscope and to find out more details about this microscope by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. So this is the main body of this microscope. All the parts are assembled inside, and there is a accessory box also provided in which I will explain you all the parts one by one. The complete microscopes comes with a wooden case. Over here you can see this wooden case easily install this microscope, and the lock and keys are also provided so that you can easily put the microscope after working with the safe environment. Here So this is the closer look of this metallurgical microscope. This is an inverted microscope. Here the samples will be provided on this top of this hole or this vernier scale which is provided, which is a mechanical stage and graduated mechanical stage which can be drive with these drivers. XY movement of ball side can be achieved. Scale on X and Y, both axes are provided so that you can easily adjust and find out the exact location of the object. Then objectives: achromate, flat field, metallurgical, corrected and anti-mound fungus of M5. Moving further, M10X, M20X and M45X or four lenses are achromatic flat field provided on this triangular axis. Then we can provide magnification up to 50x to 450x with this sliding adjustment of focusing guideways. These are the coaxial focusing guideways which can easily adjust coarse and fine movement of the focus with the slight travel. And for illumination on this end we will provide a LED bulb which has a field aperture diaphragm and filter slot. The illumination LED can be connected on this point on the left side. You can easily object and observe all the parts. On the rear side we have power connector for illumination of the LED, and on the right side we have illumination control knob so that you can easily control the intensity of the LED 5 watt bulb and observe your desired observation on the object. Now moving further to the accessories box. In this wooden box we have this illumination LED bulb. With the connector that can be easily installed on the left side, and inside this we have bulb of 5 watt LED which can provide easy illumination, and with this help of these Allen key bolts we can easily install this on the left side. Then we have wide field magnetic aperture glasses for the eye head. This can be easily installed on the observation head, and this is a 45 degree inclined observation head. With this we can easily install it on the front head, and then the eyepieces can be easily installed on this observation head. The power cable is provided to power on the circuit. Some basic filters. This one is a blue filter. And a green filter. As per your desired observation, you can use long axial single head observation output object. With this you can easily install the USB camera on the microscope and get the outputs also. Allen key to connect the observation head on the front and microscope cover, which is packed in this complete case. These are all the accessories. So now let us first install the observation head on the front. For this we will remove this cap and easily adjust vertically as per your sitting. That is how you can install the observation head on the front end. Then we will install the illumination LED on this side. Properly connect this and using this Allen key we can tighten the bolts. Make sure all the three bolts properly tightened. After tightening all the bolts, you can easily connect this connector to socket provided on the rear of this illumination LED. Now on the back side we will connect the power, and then we place the sample on the top, and after that we will install the 10x wide lenses on the observation box, observation head. Now we can remove the cover of this trinocular head, and we can place this 10x wide field pair on this, and a long observation output tube to the front. Like this. At this point you can easily install a USB camera also, so that you can observe the output on the digital image as well. The binocular body is also being manufactured and adjustable for the interpapillary distance between 55 to 75 mm. This adjustment is made by sliding the thumb grip longitudinal, and the second adjustment is dioptric ring fitted to the eyepieces, which is pieces tube and providing for independent focusing movement to compensate for any differences in two eyes. In order to focus accurately, the interpapillary distance is first read at the center disc, and the same number is set to the left image in eyepiece without disturbing the left helical, so that you can easily adjust the focus on this binocular head. So now I have connected to the power, and as I move this knob, intensity of this bulb is increased and decreased as per desired level. Now, after placing a sample on the top of this, you can easily adjust this triangular head, and using these knobs, you can easily move this to X and Y direction to properly adjust the sample and observe the desired part image with these lenses. So here our triangular head is installed with this 45x objective achromatic. Then this is the 5x piece. And there is 25x piece, and this one is 10x piece. Sorry, this one is 20x, 45x, and this one is 10x piece. So we have 5x, 10x, 20x, and 45x, 4 pieces as per the desired arrangement. So I have set this to first 5x. Then we use this sliding guideways for moving up and down to adjust the focus, which is a coarse, and for this we can easily adjust the fine tuning of this microscope on the basis of object. Now we can put any sample on this top, and using this observation head we can easily find out the images on the 5x objective lens, then for desired 10x objective lens, and you can also observe at 20x, then 45x. With this each and every lens, and using this focusing lens, focusing adjustment, you can find out up to 450x of the objective magnification. So here I have placed this camera on the eyepieces and observation head. Now if I adjust the microscope slightly, and we can observe the SMD component soldering part on this PCB that I have used to study the soldering samples. Here using the XY movements, we can easily observe the different parts on this PCB solder tract. You can observe, and as I move to the left, again we can focus using the fine and coarse focusing objects here. This is right now as at 5x image of this components. We can easily observe at different points how the soldering at PCBs and other metallurgical objects are observed. Just need to focus it slightly and proper and patiently, and we can have the outputs. Just need to move the XY axis, and we can observe the different components and parts soldered. So once you get one clear image, then after just changing the objective lenses, you can easily increase the zoom. Here I have changed it to 10x, and here we can see the proper image, more wider and more zoom image with this microscope. If we want to see again at another place, we just need to adjust the focus. And we can get different images, different parts and points of components as well. So we can get magnification up to 400x, 450x using different type of lenses.
here. These are more closer image. Adjusting XY and fine coarse adjustments, you can easily get the microscopic images through this metallurgical microscope. Here, our demonstration of this metallurgical microscope is now completed. You have seen complete assembling process of this microscope, how to use this microscope, and we have also get images of this microscopic plates and different type of metallurgical objects with different zoom facilities using this microscope completely. To get to understand the working of a metallurgical microscope using this video, and if you like the content of this video, you can like, subscribe and share our channel Tesca Global on YouTube. And also, for more details and more queries about this, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of support. Till then, thank you for watching this video, and we'll meet in the next video very soon.